in an absolutely free market, which is not what we have, but we have something that tends in that direction. In an absolutely free market, if you compete two individuals, one of whom is completely amoral, will embrace any opportunity if it makes a profit, no matter what it is, and the other individual has some limit to what they will do, well, then there's no question who wins. If we give this experiment a long enough period, the individual who will do anything will outcompete the individual with moral limits because...
Doesn't it depend on what the game is, though? Because
no.
If people find out that you have no moral limits, then they're going to remove themselves from your market.
Unfortunately not. And
no?
Here's the... I know it seems like that, and in any given round, that's true.
Okay.
But to the extent that what you're saying is, to the extent that people police... they're purchasing, and they will, you know, they will stop using Uber if Uber is ethically compromised, for example. Well, then the point is, well, what's the game? The game is to figure out which things are being monitored and not do any of the unethical things that are being monitored, but to do all of the unethical things that aren't being monitored. And so the individual who is perceiving which things they can get away with has an advantage.
That's the psychopath advantage, right?
Well, I don't even want to call it the psychopath advantage. Right. What this is that a market will train you to do this if it is unregulated. And the best that the ethically restrained person can do is compete dead even. They have no way of getting ahead because the person that is completely free, the amoral business actor, has the ability to do anything that the constrained actor has.
But doesn't this depend entirely upon what the battlefield is?
Not really. There's sort of one exception, and that exception is people who have done something that has suddenly put them in a powerful position, right? So,
Like tech people.
Right. Tech people who have skyrocketed as a result of having innovated the next big thing have not been through the markets training them to discover the landscape of what isn't being monitored that you can make a profit at.
That's one of the fascinating things about tech people in general is that these gigantic tech corporations almost all lean left.
Well, the gigantic tech corporations lean left. That's true. On the other hand, I mean, I hate to say it, but think about how Google started, right? Don't be evil.
Right.
I think they actually meant that.
Right.
Right? And the thing is, don't be evil is what it sounds like when you haven't been trained by the market to have to do whatever you have to do to beat your competition. You've just come up with the great search engine and suddenly you're on top of the world. But over time, what happens? That entity is now exposed to competition from a bunch of other entities that increasingly will find an advantage in being freer to do ethically questionable stuff. And so what it does is it forces an entity like Google to evolve in the direction of amorality. So now don't
kind
be
of happened
evil.
With China and Google. You know,
yeah.
Because Google wanted to expand into China. And so, you know, they had to make a deal with the devil, so to speak.
Right. And
they had to accept censorship.